MK Party have got a message about the Heritage Day. Wait, MK Party has got something to say, as well as EFF. They are saying no. EFF, but we know that today is basically Shaka's Day. That is now the reason other people don't want to hear anything about, oh, they don't want to celebrate this day is because it's Shaka's Day. Uh-huh. If you don't get it, forget about it. You know who wouldn't want to celebrate today's day. You know exactly who wouldn't want to celebrate this day. But you and I, we're definitely going to celebrate the day. Are we? Oh, we know. We will definitely celebrate the day because it's a Heritage Day. But I also feel like the day has lost its meaning. So what I'm going to do, MK Party on the 24th of September, statement on Heritage Day, a hello celebration, meet landless, poverty, and inequality. EFF seeks to be singing in the same hymnal book too. EFF have got this to say. Just give me a moment. Where is the statement from EFF? I think it's this one. Remember that MK Party said, they said, hello and what? People are remain landless. EFF said this on the 24th of September, 2024. Economic Freedom Fighter EFF commemorate Heritage Day with a firm rejection of hello and symbolic unit that this day now represents. What was once a day rooted in the history of resilience, known as Shaka Day, honoring the visionary leader who united Zulu Nation, is now a diluted celebration of cultural diversity, devoid of a reflection of the real condition under which our people continue to suffer. I think I'm reading it in the spirit of EFF, man. You know, EFF wouldn't say, the Heritage Day, that's unite our people, you know. It's a day that was created to have the EFF wouldn't read it that way. EFF would be like, a day that is supposed to reflect on our Heritage Day. A day that is supposed to have show signs of resilience. Not this day of a Heritage Day, you know, like a celebration of diversity, you know. I'm glad about this because, to be quite honest, it's only now that I'm reading this, I'm like, wow. Things like these, guys, I wouldn't have thought of it. It has been made to be about cultural activity instead of being about how resilient these people were. I'm very glad that this political consciousness that the EFF and MK Party are creating, it's very it's spot on. I'm very grateful about that. Right? I'm one person who was very ignorant about the fact that this day was never about it was never about celebrating diversity and all these things. It was about celebrating the resilience of Black people. I'm glad this lesson. I will say to MK Party and EFF, it doesn't go unnoticed. I'm one who was ignorant about it. I acknowledge I was ignorant about it. What about you? Wait, before we continue, take a look at this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financial contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying?
we will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Okay, now let's proceed then. They continue to say the following. I'm going to go to EFF when I'm done here. They said, as we stand in 2024, how can we celebrate heritage in a country where black people and Africans in particular, majority remain economically enslaved? The land remains in the hands of few, with 72% of private-owned land controlled by white minority. The wealth of our nation is still concentrated in the hands of the descendants of colonizers, while the majority of South Africans are relegated to townships, informal settlement, and rural areas with no access to basic services like clean pipe water, dignified sanitation, and electricity. What is Heritage Day? They say, what Heritage Day are we celebrating with the women of this country are not free? Women are still oppressed by violence, poverty, systematic exclusion from economy. The unemployed rate for African women remains staggering high. Those who do not work are subjected to expropriative conditions. The government has failed to deliver the promise of true gender equality with policies that continue to entrench patriarchal oppression rather than dismantle it. We also cannot ignore the racial division that our society. Racism runs deep from the workplace to our schools. Even government policies, our people still experience the effect of racial inequality daily when our children marginalized in their own schools, where they have to learn in colonizers' language, isolated from their mother's tongue. The inclusion of our rainbow nation has failed, and we live in a society that continue to marginalize the African majority, while white supremacist institutions and individual operate with what? Okay. MK Party decided Nabo to say the following. I'm looking at myself there. There's a screen there. One day I will show you guys how I record this. It's very important. I'm going to show you how I do this video behind the scene. MK Party says, today, MK Party, we lament the hollowness of the Heritage Day. A day that meant to celebrate the unity and diversity of our nation, but instead shakily highlights the deep-rooted injustice and remain unaddressed. Despite 30 years of democracy, the African majority remain landless. Poverty, you know what I'm saying? We've already stated that. We stand on the shoulders of African kings, chiefs, warriors, who fought vigilantly against colonial conquest. Leaders like King Shaka, King Cetshwayo, Chief Bambatha Gamancinza, King Hinta ga Watwatangbonlo, Chief, they go on to name those people. But yeah, I can't see some of these people, guys. You know, most I'm reading from a phone, so yeah, it's not gonna be great. But nonetheless, it has been a nice thing for me to learn that Heritage Day FM was never made for what it has become today. Heritage Day, for me, it's a great lesson. Great lesson. What has been your observation? I would like to hear you in the comment section below. So, I'll see you on the next episode. Till such a time, good people, please take care.